Real chip ideas.
Seriously, I am like a chip connoisseur of size. Like, everything's
too big. Yeah. I don't know, can't even do that. Is that like a statement or is it just a thing?
Oh, it's really a thing.
No, but seriously, somebody has to
snap it. Yeah, I don't know.
The stuff they want to put in the in the bags, you're more than welcome to do so.
Every day for a week we would try to hear the wind rush. Feel the chill. It was an Indian chief and he'd say, Maggie, do you want to dance? I really need this job. Please God, I need this job. I've got to get it wrong. To our company? And she'd say, what? Are you ashamed of your own mother?
So many faces all around, and here we go.
Is Dad up there? Dad, are you up here?
A scholarship to college. A scholarship to college. So I went. Yes, I went.
Ooh, sorry. Giving your attention, do I really have to mention she's the...
I don't want to do the last one. Keep going. Thank you.
Richard, give us off the top, even just the step, kick, kick.
Again, step, kick, kick, leap, kick, touch. Again, step, kick, kick, leap, kick, touch.
All combination facing away from the mirror from the top. A
like, oh, maybe I'll get Mike, maybe I'll get the tapper, like, maybe I'll do that, but like, never. So when I got the casting list and I see my name, Mike, number 81, Harold Limeland, I'm just like, okay. Woo, I was like, I'm ready.
I'm watching this, go hit her hat. I can do that.
I don't know, like, it's just great to have the support of, like, A, your director, who believes in you so much, believes in me so much, and then, like, having your friends there, like, having people, like, just cheering you on. I mean, like, knowing that you're not the most comfortable doing this, like, you get really nervous, but at the same time, it's like, so what? Kill it.
Nothing flies. Hell, I can do that. I can do that.
No, it's just nice to have the atmosphere, but yeah, I'm so nervous. Like, trust me, I get nervous. This whole like big tap number. And I remember just looking at my mom like, Mom, I can't do that.
Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town. I've blocked it out.
Oh, Bobby?
He's crazy. I literally think he should be institutionalized. Just because he lights people on fire and stuff, I don't know. I don't get it.
Let's see. Do you want to hear about all the wonderful and exciting things that happened in my life? Or do you want the truth?
It was fun. It's quiet sometimes, but it's fun.
It's redundant.
Okay, Bobby, back in line. Sheila!
Yes, you want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
To talk.
What do you want to know about me first?
When I originally got the role, I was really freaked out because I kind of thought you could just play her as a huge bitch and that's all you could do, you know what I mean? Or you could get all serious about it, but I didn't really know where I was going to grab personal experience from, because my family is pretty good and tight and nothing bad's ever happened. So I was like, okay, she's got a fucked up life, how do I relate this to my life?
What's that supposed to mean?
Because I'm very strong.
Maybe too strong?
Look, am I doing something you don't like? You told me.
It became easier as I just kind of
your attitude.
Rooted it in things that aren't necessarily my family.
Tell me about your parents.
And it was really cool because I always get really self-conscious about acting. Singing, I can just go and I'll sing a song and I'm like, okay, great, that was good. Even the acting and singing comes easier, but just doing something straight acting always makes me a little uncomfortable.
Daddy always thought that he married beneath him. That's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably her very last chance.
This is the first time that I feel as comfortable with acting as I do in a song. It's just like singing, it's easy, which is nice because I feel like it's taking that extra step into the real world of knowing how to do it all. So that's cool. And I've learned so much and had such a great experience, and everybody is stupidly talented in this cast that we get to work with, and I think everyone's casting perfectly. I love my song I get to sing at the ballet, because ballet is one of my favorite kinds of dancing, so I'm really happy with my role. I love working with Melissa and Mike and Val. It's an amazing team, and I'm really happy. I can't talk anymore.
Family issues kind of person.
Oh, but I guess not.
I did have fantastic fantasy life. I used to dance a really big move with my arms up like this. My fantasy was that it was an Indian chief. And he said to me, Peggy, do you want to dance? And I said, Daddy, I would love to dance.
Let me see. It's great playing her. It's fun to, you know, like, take your experiences that you see in other people's lives and put them in your own life. And she's definitely a challenge because I'm not a shy person. And the high note, it's pretty awesome. Makes me feel free. Love it. On top of the world.
Nailed it.
So, pretty good experience.
Technique and in the real world there's so many great dancers, and I thought, like, man, like, I probably won't ever get to be in the chorus line. And then when I found out it was a show we were doing this year, please, I hope I'm in that show. And I didn't really know anything about Christine when I got cast, but she's been so much fun.
Character Al. I found him a bit of a challenge because for a long time I did not know how to really portray this character. I was always trying to find something either in the text or maybe in the song or maybe talks of what people have said about him or any kind of direction Melissa would give me. So for a while it was just a big struggle for me, and I found that was my biggest gap to really overcome, was trying to find who is Al, how is he like, what is he like, because I don't want to be my typical over dramatic schmacky schmacky kind of guy, right, like what I usually do and what I usually love.
I'm Al DeLuca, January 11th, I'm 30 years old, and I come from the Bronx.
I'm Christine Orrick, Christine Evelyn Orrick, born September 1st, and I'm 22.
Tell me.
Getting to be married to someone in the line, Al, is great because we're the only people who aren't just like soloists. Like, we're a pair, so we can work off each other, and I have that like support team there. And we've been working really hard at kind of making that bond. Like, we haven't taken our wedding rings off all week, even outside of rehearsals, just to kind of feel that way.
Just your usual lovey-dovey kind of guy who supports his young wifey, who is a very nervous and hyper kind of girl, and he just wants to be there to support her.
Except, I have this little,
problem.
See, I really could sing. I could never really sing. What I couldn't do was...
sing.
I have trouble with all the things all around. It's terrifying. See, I really could hear my show was lower or was
higher.
Which is why I disappear when someone said, let's start up.
Since I'm tone deaf, there's not really there's not many nerves involved. I can just go out there and have lots of fun, right? Because the worse I sound and the more I crack, the better my performance is. Honestly, and probably the most important thing about my character is my scrunchie. Where is it? There, see? You were talking to Paige, and now you're talking to Christine.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Pit singers, we're gonna put you by the mics. The rest of you guys kind of hang around here.
I'm Mike. I'm the music director for a chorus line at St. Clair College. Mm-hmm. And this piece was such a great choice for St. Clair. It makes so many opportunities for so many people. There's so many lead roles, and there's a lot of demands put on our students to have to, you know, come up with their character and create their character, and there's opportunities to draw on personal experiences. And I think in many ways the students can relate to the characters they play in terms of being unsure about where they're going or what's next for them. Just like Cassie, you know, comes up at the end of the show, you know, what do you do if you can't dance anymore? And it's, in many ways, what are you going to do when you leave this program? Or what comes next is always that sort of uncertainty about what you're going to be out of a job today, and what are you going to do tomorrow? Or Cassie not being able to find work. So from the students, it's such a great opportunity to draw on those personal experiences and that uncertainty in your own career and your own education. So for that, it's just a great opportunity for the students.
Yeah.
We're doing chorus line with what I call the skeleton crew. Just me on piano, a great bass player Mike Palazzolo, a drummer Kevin Venny, and two horns, a saxophonist who's playing actually three saxophones, clarinet and flute, and a trumpet player who happens to be Leanna's dad. Just five of us, but they're doing a great job and they're getting a great sound with just a few musicians.
Well, he set me straight.
helped me out. I was...
Hi, I'm Alicia, and I play Connie in the show. What's funny about her is that she's supposed to be 4'10" in the show, but we have to change it because I'm not 4'10". So I'm actually 5'4", but we have to change it to say 5'2". So it's like, I don't know, it's weird trying to be the shortest one in the cast when there's boys beside me who are like the same height as me. But I get to wear flats during the whole show, which is a plus. So that's pretty fun. Everyone's like feet are sore and I'm happy, I'm good.
5'2", 5'2", but I kept hoping and praying. I used to hang around the barrel bar by the hour, hoping I'd step just an inch more. Cause I was into dancing then, and I was good. I wanted so much to grow up to be a raven ballerina.
Show me your love. Meet Daddy Me.
was born 6'10". I'm 27. Got that? And I was born in a Hollywood bed in the Bronx.
Go on, Diana.
Go on what?
I've got Ooch texting me and she's picking on me. What else is there? And all of a sudden she says, by the way, you're Diana. And I have it saved. I screenshotted it because I was so excited.
You can get angry. I'll act. I'll perform. But I can't just talk. Please. I'm too nervous.
Better relax.
Listen, I really don't mind talking. I just can't be the first. Please.
You want this job, don't you?
Sure, I want the job.
And it says, don't joke about that, babe. That's not nice. And then she's like, no, seriously. Megan's story, .. Diana. And then I threw up. But, like, I was in the back row. So I couldn't do anything.
Anyway, she's got us up on stage with our legs around each other, one in back of the other. And he says, okay, Diana, you're going to be on stage.
We're going to do improvisation today.
Now,
you're in a bobsled. And it's snowing out. And it's cold.
Okay, go. Every day for a week we try to feel the motion, feel the motion down the hill. Every day for a week we would try to hear the wind rush, hear the wind rush, feel the chill.
Hold one of those hard moments where you're like, do I get up and go throw up, or do I just kind of like sit here and be quiet? And I did one of those, and I remember Mulan sitting beside me just with this face like, oh my god, are you okay? And I just handed her my phone, and then I'll never forget Mulan looked at me, she's like,
dressing room, and we did a lot of dressing. Anyway, she
on the court, and I'm playing Judy Turner. It was a really cool experience because I'm kind of like a comedic character, and so it was really, obviously, a really fun role to play.
Hi, I'm Judy Turner, but I'm really the Judy Turner.
And you could do a lot with it and take it to the extreme. It's kind of close to my personality, unfortunately, but so it was pretty easy to connect to.
Oh, and I thought I'll have to pass the test.
Good. Next. Worst thing in school was every time the teacher called on me, might be hard. Desk like this, and the teacher would say, "Stand up straight." I can't. I have a pain in my side. Stand up straight. Or walking down the hall, you walk like this. All your books stack up in front of you.
Huh? I thought it was just me. I thought I was the next thing out.
You are.
I did too. I mean, it didn't go down for like 3 years.
What's the worst? Look at a bus, eh? Bingo! Oh, and then there was the time I was making up the back seat with the outfit. We were neck, and I was feeling your boobs. And feeling your boobs. And after about an hour or so, she goes, "Ooh, don't you want to feel anything else?" And I suddenly thought to myself, no, I don't.
Did that come as a surprise to you?
Well, I guess, yeah, I mean, it was the first time I realized that I was homosexual. And I said, gee, I'll never get to wear nice clothes. And I felt
confidence and portraying that confidence on stage, because I've already been given this obstacle of playing a male role, I need to work so much harder to make it believable in a female role.
Margaret Mary Houlihan. Couldn't she just die?
I get to wear a mic for the first time, which is really cool. Not what I thought it was going to be. Because I would always see people in other shows getting mics, and I would be like, oh, I want to be that person. And now realizing it's not as glamorous as you think it would be.
That was my plan. New York, New York, here I come! Except I had this one minor problem. You see, I was ugly as sin. I was ugly, homely, skinny, unattractive, and flat as a pancake. Get the picture?
Getting to do my first solo song is amazing, especially in the show, because Val is a really nice character.
Discount looks freak, and I'm still on unemployment. Get to bore my own enjoyment. That ain't it, kid. That ain't it, kid. Discount looks freak, it's like the
who were not necessarily like the most pretty, the most popular in high school when we were little. And she, now she's like all the confidence. So it's good. It's good to play well. It's really fun. To anyone who's ever been a part of theater, it's a very important show. Everyone who's ever been in any aspect of the theater can really relate to it. But I'm sure everyone or someone in everyone's life has been
unsupportive or thought that maybe this wasn't the greatest job in the world for us, but at the end of the day, all of us love it, and this is why we do it. It doesn't matter. It's all what we did for love. It's been such a good experience working on this show as someone who's not a dancer first and foremost. It's been quite a challenge. So I've loved getting to work with Melissa. She, if there's anyone who knows about loving what they do, it's her and Mike as well. Those two are two of the most passionate artists that I've ever worked with. And I hope that maybe one day we will get to work again on probably not a chorus line, but maybe something like it.
To have something that I can believe in, to have something to be, use me, choose me.
I just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Cassie.
Give me somebody to dance with, give me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world.
Starting position is turned in third. Hips and shoulders on the diagonal, elbows up, chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready? A 5, 6, 7. Chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8.
Paul said, Marco, it's my stage name. Marilia Zenefray Ramirez, born in Spanish Harlem, 24.
This is the first show that I've ever played a character who was based off somebody in real life, as opposed to being thought up. Somebody else's actual words is probably the hardest thing in the world because you want to do it justice. And if you do it wrong, it sounds so fake, but when you feel like you do it right, it sounds right.
And just as my parents turned to go, my dad turned to the producer and said, "Take care, my son."
So, being Paul is a weird experience, but it's a good experience.
Selling a smile that I love to dance smile.
How would you feel?
Everyone's dream song, right? It describes everything that we do and why we do it.
Kiss today, goodbye.
Going.
Yeah. Okay, so everybody, let's take our standby.